Hello viewers, in this video we are going to discuss about one new disease condition, that is the anemia. Part 1 anemia we are going to discuss in this video. Okay, it is also one disease condition for the children. It will be there in the child health nursing subject. Okay, the unit is the 6th unit, that is the children with various disorders and diseases. Okay, in this one disease condition, that is the anemia. Before going to discuss in detail about disease condition of anemia, we have to learn about RBC. Okay, RBC nothing but red blood cells. It will be there in the blood. What is the function of RBC? Okay, RBC is having one important function, that is the transportation of nutrients, transportation of oxygen. Yes, is it right? Yes, it's exactly true. Why? Because in the presence of RBC only, the oxygen will be transported from the lungs to tissues. Okay, from the lungs to tissues, the oxygen will be supplied or transportation process will be running. Okay, next, in this hemoglobin is there, no? What is the meaning of hemoglobin? Hemoglobin is nothing but it is one type of red color protein. It will be there in the RBCs. Okay, in this what is the function of this type of hemoglobin? It is also giving the transportation, and it will also exchange of gases and providing some water, ATP, energy to the particular body parts. Okay, this is the normal functions of RBC and hemoglobin. Okay, next we are going to discuss about anemia definition. Okay, in this anemia what happens means decreased or reduction of RBC production. Okay, RBC production is there, no? That RBC production should be reduced. What happens means hemoglobin concentration is below. Hemoglobin concentration also less than the normal level. Okay, for example, different age groups of children is there, no? In the society, what means, for example, children's, infants, newborns, and adults, adolescents, old age, young age. Okay, like that, some stages of human beings is there. Okay, in this, according to the age group, the hemoglobin percentage will be there. Okay, the concentration of hemoglobin is there according to the WHO. In this disease condition, what happens means according to their age group, the hemoglobin percentage will be reduced. Okay, that's why we are called as the anemia. Anemia nothing but less production of RBC, less concentration of hemoglobin than the normal levels. Okay, this is the definition of anemia. Okay, who are suffering with this type of anemia disease condition? Those are having the one symptom like decreased RBC production. Okay, then the RBC production decreased, that's why they are having the so many of diseases. Okay, so many of functions should be systemic failure. Okay, next we are going to discuss about what happens means this RBC production decreased, hemoglobin percentage also decreased. That's why the oxygen capacity will also decreased in the body. Okay, in the blood, the oxygen capacity also decreased. Why? Because in the presence of oxygen, in the presence of RBC and hemoglobin, the body parts will get some oxygen from that proteins. Okay, the RBCs and hemoglobins reduced less means the in the body, especially in the blood or in the body parts, oxygen capacity also reduced. Next, we are going to discuss about according to WHO, what is the normal level of RBC hemoglobin. Okay, in this first of all, we are going to discuss about WHO nothing but World Health Organization. Okay, in this World Health Organization gives some measurements or some type of percentage for hemoglobin according to their age group. Okay, who are having below 6 months of age group children, those are having the hemoglobin percentage should be 9.5 grams per deciliter. Okay, who are newborn, from the newborn or from the first month to 6 months, below 6 months of age group children having the hemoglobin percentage in that 9.5 grams per deciliter. Okay, next, the children who are having the age group from the 6 year to 14 years of age group. Okay, from the 6 years to 14 years of age group, those are having their hemoglobin percentage, that is the 12 grams per deciliter. Okay, 6 to 14 years of age group children, their hemoglobin percentage 6 to 12 grams. Okay, next, another one is children's 6th month of age group. Okay, from the 6th month of age group up to 6 years. 6th month to 6th years of age group children having the hemoglobin percentage, that is the 11 grams per deciliter. Okay, below 6 months people or below 6 months children having the 9.5 grams per deciliter. Okay, 6 months to 6 years of age group children having the 11 grams per deciliter. Okay, next, another one is the 6 years to 14 years of age group children having that 12 grams per deciliter. Okay, next, above 14 years of age group children, in that males especially, the males are having the 13 grams per deciliter. Okay, in that 14 years above children, especially female girls, okay, those are having the 12 grams per deciliter. Hemoglobin percentage 12 grams per deciliter. These are the percentage given by the WHO, World Health Organization. Okay, who are having below levels, those children are having the anemia disease condition. For example, we are assessing one children like below 6th months of age group children, those are having a 6.5 or 3.5 deciliter per grams, means who are having 3.5 or 3 grams per deciliter, their hemoglobin percentage, means those are affected or those are suffering with the anemia disease condition. Okay, like that we have to decide. That's why we have to learn in detail about in that student period or in that training period. Why? Because once the children is coming to the hospital, they are suffering chief complaints, means according to, based on the chief complaints, we have to decide the children will be suffering with the anemia or leukemia or hemophilia, whatever it may be, what are the disease condition is there. Okay, that's why we have to learn what is the normal, what is the abnormal. Okay, then when we have to differentiate which is normal, which is abnormal, then only we are having the skillful knowledge regarding human being's health. Okay, next, another one is we have to discuss about WHO grading anemia. Okay, according to the WHO, the anemia gradings, what is, when we have to call the children will be suffering with the anemia disease condition, means in this hemoglobin percentage between 10 grams per deciliter. Okay, 10 grams per deciliter is there, means then we have to decide the children will be suffering with the mild anemia. Okay, next, hemoglobin percentage in between the 7 grams per deciliter is there, means we have to decide the children will be suffering with the moderate anemia. Okay, next, hemoglobin percentage below 7 grams per deciliter is there. The hemoglobin percentage below 7 grams per deciliter is there, means the children will be suffering with the severe anemia. Okay, like that we have to decide. These are the percentage given by the WHO. Okay, then only we have to decide the children is suffering, the person or the patient will be suffering with the these mild anemia, moderate anemia or severe anemia, depending upon these measurements. Okay, next, we are discussed about clinical grading. Okay, according to the clinical grading, means depending upon the some symptoms, the children are showing, the patients are showing some type of symptoms means depending upon the symptoms. Okay, one symptom having one anemia, one type of anemia. Okay, another symptom having another type of anemia. Okay, like that we differentiate means depending upon the clinical pathogenicity of the children. Okay, in that first one is the pallor conjunctiva, means pale conjunctiva. When we are assessing, when you are doing physical examination of the children's conjunctiva will be pale in color, means the children is suffering with the mild anemia. Okay, next another symptom like the skin. When we are assessing of your children, the skin of the children having a pale color means the children suffering with the moderate anemia. Okay, when we are assessing the children are having a pale palmar surface of the extremities. Okay, who are having a pale nails or pale palmar surfaces? Okay, those children are having the severe anemia. Okay, depending upon the these clinical gradings, we have to decide the children will be suffering with the mild anemia or moderate anemia or severe anemia. Okay, these are the gradings will be given by the WHO. Okay, depending upon these gradings only, we have to decide, we have to identify, we have to declare it regarding children's health. Okay, the children will be suffering with the this type of anemia disease condition. Okay, this is given or these assessment will be or this type of diagnosis will be done under the or in the presence of physician only. Okay, without physician, as a nurse, we are not finalize the disease condition of children. Okay, why? Because in the presence of physician only, the physician will give correct diagnosis regarding children or patients. Okay, as a nurse, we have to provide special care. Okay, which care will be announced, which care will be given by the or which care will be prescribed. Okay, which type of medications will be prescribed by the physician, then only we have to proceed. Okay, without a physician, you are not proceeding your own decision. Okay, this is the regarding anemia disease condition part 1 video. Okay, thank you everyone.